Yo, what up, world? It's your boy Eric, back with a fragrance slash review slash just some more fragrance talk for the fragrance world. All right. As you can see from the topic, title, whatever you want to call it, this is Invictus versus the new version of Invictus that was previously released, and it's the Aqua version. All right. So really quick, let me just tell y'all my story on how, tell you just what's going on. I'm just leaving Macy's, and where I stay, it's back to school. So today's Monday, and it's back to school. So as my lady was getting kids ready for school, you know, I'm still in bed, and I wake up, and I have a gift card from Macy's that my girl gave me just for being a good dad. And just a good person all summer, and just, I guess, forever, all year round. All right, so I ended up getting a Macy's gift card this morning, and it immediately made me just say, hey, what do I want to get from Macy's? All right, so with that being said, y'all, I was actually an Invictus hater. I was a hater when I first smelt it. I smelt it on a sheet of paper, and it was just kind of loud and just disrespectful. And then I think I smelled maybe four or five other fragrances that day, which I shouldn't have done. And then one other day I went in the mall and I said, let me try that out again. And I sprayed it and it did smell more pleasantful. But honestly, y'all, I was going through like problems at the time. And my nose wasn't just really up to par, but I did like it more the second time. So you know what I'm saying? I liked it enough to like not like it and then come back to it. So that's what led me to actually this fragrance. Now, by me not liking this fragrance, what led me to it was I was actually about to go to Macy's and purchase the Aqua version of the Invictus. Y'all forgive me if my words are kind of in and out. Forgive me. All right, I'm just trying to get this story out and get to this little quick, you know, review or whatever, right? So just to make a long story short, I was intentionally about to get the Invictus, the Aqua version. But when I went to the mall and I went to Macy's and the lady sprayed it on my arm, y'all, it smelled exactly like two fragrances, y'all. The Paco Rabanne, whatever you want to call it, Aqua version. It smelled just like, I'm going to move this bottle for a second, y'all. But it smelled just like Versace. And that is the, what is that, the Versace Per Homme. And it also smelled just like a Laura Homme Sport. That is exactly what, I don't know if it's going on. All right, I don't know if y'all can see this or not, but that's not cool. But however the case may be, y'all, that is exactly what the Aqua version smelled like to me. It smelled just like Chanel or Laura Homme Sport, or you could have went with the Versace. And even as I'm smelling it now on my arm, so that's what made me go with the original version. All right, now I really never liked the original version because it was kind of loud to me. And y'all, a quick testimony, any fragrance that you didn't like, go back, give it maybe a year or so, 6 months to a year, and go back and try it out because you might think different. All right, so just my opinion on the Versus, the Invictus, the original versus the Aqua, I would have to go with this version just because, let me move it back a little bit. I would have to go with this version just because it's not many fragrances to smell just like this, but there are a lot of more Aqua fragrances to smell like the Aqua version of the Invictus. So yeah, just really quick, y'all, that's just my opinion. Give this, you know, a try. Some people, I know a lot of people don't like it. It's like a love or a hate scent. I actually hated it at first, and then I just grew to kind of love that loud bubblegum, you know, just very good scent. It's just a very cool scent to me. And even if it's not the best, it's just a very great, great, great scent that I will enjoy wearing. Because some days you might don't want to smell like your best, but you do want to smell good and catchy. And that's what this fragrance does. It catches your attention. All right, and really, really quick too. I think that my next fragrance that I'm looking into purchasing would be the Paco Rabanne 1 Million, but the intense version, because I actually have that on my hand as well. And man, it smells really good. And the last thing I wanted y'all to know is the Invictus, it projects and it's more stronger than a lot of smells, because when my girl had got out the car and she got back in the car, that was the first smell that she said she smelled on me. So yeah, man, just not trying to be too much longer. Let me know what you feel about the Invictus. Let me know if you tried the Aqua version. And let me know what you think the Aqua version smells like. You know what I'm saying? Let me know which one you like the best as well. But me personally, y'all, I'm going with this version. And I have my reasons. I like the loud smell. I grew to love it. I grew to enjoy it. And I like the bubblegum smell. I like the sweet smell. You know, it's good working scent. I don't think it will offend a lot of people around. Oh, and most importantly, my girl said she liked it. So I think that like made it go up 10 times more of my liking, because my girl said, you know, it's a winner in her category of smelling it on me. So I had to get it. Oh, and how much did I pay for it? I got this gift set. I hope my camera doesn't die, but I got this gift set for about $100 along with my gift card. It made it $70, you guys, and it came with a few more samples. She gave me Chanel Allure Homme. I got a few Chrome Intense samples, and I have Burberry Mr. Burberry. So yeah, really cool samples. I hadn't tried them out. Obviously, you know, I got this already, so hadn't tried out the Chrome Intense or the Mr. Burberry, but you know, I might try it out and give y'all a review. All right, y'all, hope this video helped. Like, subscribe, comment if it did, if you like it, if you don't like it, cool. And till next time, one love, peace.